Today I will present about my topic. My topic is about use of learning tools in teaching English. I'm using YouTube in the EFL classroom. Before that, I will explain about what the tools to teaching English. I want to explain about what is learning and the different e-learning and different e-learning and learning. E-learning is we use electronic to in learning process such as computer, CD room, satellite, and etc. This is a concept of e-learning. In e-learning, teacher control learning. It means the teacher can choose what the material that he want to give to the student. And then this is a learning control learning. It means the student can choose that what he want, the choose what the material that he want to teach him. And this is a traditional physical classroom learning in the past, and today we using online learning. Okay, this is the evolution of education technology. In the past, we using leaf to teaching, leaf for to make a note, and then by the times the technology in education have moving. For the first we using leaf, and then the letter, telephone, television, satellite, and the last until now we using in education technology. So there are many tools that we can use in teaching English. The first is smart boards, podcasting, internet, mobile phones, social media, YouTube, blog, Skype, and etc. Internet is the most popular technology right now. In internet, we can use in teaching English. For the example, student can send assignment via email to her teacher. And then the teacher can send the homework via email too. And then the Skype. In teaching English, we can use Skype. For the example, if the teacher cannot come to the class, we can use Skype in video call to give the sharing information without coming in the class, but we can talk face to face by Skype. The third it's podcasting. Today in listening subject, we every teacher use the podcasting. Why? Because in teaching English, we can download the record, maybe make the record to the record conversation, and then we can download that the records from the podcasting. Podcasting is not the site, it's not just the site, but maybe it's same like the tape radio and tape recorder. And then this blog. In the blog, we can improve our writing skill and reading skill. Why? Because in the blog, we can write about the thesis, maybe the essay or etc. And this is example for the blog. You can see.
Yes, I see.
Okay. Smart boards. Everyone know about the smart boards?
No. Yeah. No, not really.
But you ever watch Maria Teguh talk show?
Yes. Yes.
Yeah. Maria Teguh in his talk show using the smart boards. When they write something in the table, that what he want write is quiet.
And then the mobile phones. Everyone using mobile phones, right now?
Yeah.
Mobile phones help you to share information and then can take a video or the pictures. And then for the English teaching, you can record your voice or the conversation, and then you can share it with your friends. So the mobile phones so help you to teaching English. And social media. All of you use the social media. Social media, the general function is to sharing information. But in teaching English, we can use the social media in teaching English. Like for the example, you can share about the record in the Instagram or in the Snapchat. And then for the sharing about the information about your material, you can share with Facebook or Twitter today. And the media social, not all the young people using it, but all of the people use this media social today. And this is the last, using YouTube in the EFL classroom. YouTube, maybe all of you know about what is the YouTube. YouTube is the site. There are many video in YouTube. In EFL classroom, we can use YouTube to share video and share video or information. And in YouTube, we have the three potential applications. For the first one is listening and speaking. We can improve our listening and speaking skills if using YouTube, because in the YouTube have the video and the sounds that we can listen, and we can replay to speak what the video say. And then the another potential is reading and writing. In the video, we can read. Maybe not all of the video in YouTube is such as the video or audios like action, but maybe some the video such as the PowerPoint maybe or essay in the YouTube in YouTube. So if the video is not like the film, you can read the material, and then you can improve your reading skill and writing skill. The last is the word analysis. Word analysis is mean like not of all the people use YouTube is the native speaker, but the Indians people, Indonesian people, Thailand people, Chinese people using the YouTube. So how many Indonesian that they used to make video in YouTube? So word analysis is mean like a circle that we or a group that we can use to communicate with another people have the different Indonesian or different culture. So word analysis is mean like the group that we can that have a potential application in YouTube. Okay. The conclusion is there are many tools that we can use to teaching English. So the tools help you to teaching English, and we have to use it well to apply the tools to teaching English. Okay, maybe that's all my presentation. Thank you for your